All right, welcome back. As part of the data scraping demo, we are done with creating different modules for different activities like search input for user and launching browser and search activity. Almost we are done with each and every activity. The time is to integrate with the Aureo framework. So let me come back to main.xaml. As we know, there are different stages in provides Aureo framework. First thing is like initialization step. So initialization step is responsible for reading data from the config and initializing all applications required to process. So let me give the description or the title data scraping demo I have added here. And let me get into this installation stage and scroll down where initial applications flow, open the workflow. Nothing is there, only log message is there. Let me add our first activity to get the user input. Okay, I just added input for user workflow. Click on the workflow. So this workflow, what we have done, the first thing is it will ask for user select his choice for searching recipe, fruits, vegetables or meat related recipes. So when user select, then it gives a sub choice for under, suppose if he select fruits, then it gives the choice for user to opt for like apple, banana, grapes, whatever he selected, that will be processed for searching. Okay, so what I will do here is, the first thing is it, the data whatever user select from this input dialog, that has to pass different workflows. From user will select from the user input for user workflow, and that data should pass on to this internal application and from the main. Okay, because in the main we are having different process that we need to pass the data between the stage, different stages of Aureo framework. Okay, so for that, what I have done, instead of variable, I created a out argument so that whatever the data selected, it will be stored as a out argument, out sub choice argument. And you can see here out sub choice as an out parameter, out direction and string. Okay, so that will be stored in the out sub choice argument. Fine, so we are done with the input for user and get into that upper hierarchy. So here we need to import that arguments. So what I'm doing, out sub choice out, I'm just importing. Okay, that is also done. And here also we need to pass out sub choice because it should be available to the next main. So whatever the data we will get it from this initall applications workflow, that has to be passed onto this main.xaml. In the main.xaml, again, we need to import arguments, right? So what I've done here, in the main.xaml, I created a variable recipe, because in main.xaml, we need to use that variable into different stages like process, get transaction process, etc. So recipe I created. And I'm assigning the output arguments to recipe. Okay, so that will assign to the recipe variable. So we in the main.xaml, we will get the recipe value. So for testing purpose, what I will do is I'll just drag and drop a message box and I'll put the recipe. Okay, recipe. So we'll see whatever user selected in the input for user workflow, that should be available in the main.xaml. Let me run this process. Okay, let me run this one. Let us see how it works. So first we need to get the prompt for different categories like fruits, vegetables and meat. I'll select fruits. Okay, then I'll get fruits opted, and banana I'll see. I'll select banana. Banana, I got it. Okay, in the main.xaml also, we are receiving the user selected data. Fine. In the coming videos, we will see how to integrate other activities with Aureo framework. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.